And then once we set the location, I can contact my dad. Yep. Unless we are otherwise attacked or improvised before that situation goes.
And welcome back to Toka D-Bowl. I mean, Toka Tales. Episode, I just called this one 5.1 onto the spire. So we're going to jump to, you guys take the teleport.
Yep.
Because
after lunch,
we spent quite the town day.
Yep. Had a lot of shit to do.
Day after Xmas and
busy as shit.
And you guys.
Platinum did go.
Platinum did go. But Krampus has paid off.
Isn't it amazing how you always tend to spend more money after Christmas than right before it?
I'm not going to lie about myself, my Christmas gift after Christmas. So I can't really complain.
Sweet. I hope you guys get the high kill scores. Sludie's playing Overwatch with her husband, and she's going to lurk. So she can laugh at herself getting killed, her husband getting killed, and
us getting not killed.
No death. No, we're not dying on a, you know, side mission by my regard, not reputation to justify it.
Not even a legitimate job.
Yeah, right.
It's a side part of a job.
It's a personal investment.
True.
Can Fee actually res you?
No.
All right, I didn't think so.
No, it's all you right now.
Yeah, I was just gonna say. Yeah, that's all me.
She hasn't quite gotten the revivify, where she can res you within like 5 rounds or 10 yeah. rounds of you dying.
Damn, that takes forever.
It costs like 100 gold diamond every time you cast it.
I thought it was 500.
It was like 100 gold for revivify, like 500 gold for actual resurrect. True resurrection is like 1,000 gold or something like that.
I like mine better.
To me, personally, magic is a wonderful thing, but it's a manipulation of energy. So I can understand the arcane nature of it, where you're using materials, components, a shit ton of math and education in order to get an effect.
Right.
Okay? It makes sense. You know, if you're studying it long enough in order to be able to do it, then you can learn how to do it that way. But then you have these assholes that are just, like, naturally able to do it. And that's where I made Pry Bone for.
Now everyone's an asshole.
See, here I am writing, like, my sub-company CEO ranking. Now asshole. That, you know, there's Shell Shock Industries. And I laugh because you're like, what are those innate meta-human mutant assholes that just, you know, as I'm thinking of my electric bender from childhood, just throwing around electricity like a ball, like a toy, occasionally blowing up robots. You know, it was a wonderful life.
He's blowing up Timmy!
Oh, that was intentional. The robots were unintentional. Yeah. Timmy was like, hey, Timmy, time to die.
Timmy!
But if you look at that from an outside perspective of any other kid that you might have gone to school with, you were that freaking asshole, weren't you? That one that was like the super smart kid in a class full of idiots. You know?
Yeah, sounds
the I look at my intelligence and I'm like, yeah, I probably was that smart ass.
The jock in a room full of nerds, you know?
But that's the other thing. It's kind of a weird perspective because, yeah, the jock in the room full of woods, the only kid in a country. In retrospect, it's like, yeah, I guess maybe you're right. I might have been a know-it-all.
No, they were my kids.
We never really went over that, so I really thought this whole time I'm the only kid in Lethal because...
Do you really think that you slummed it enough to go to the village all the time to go with the village kids?
Like I said, I was the only kid in that. No, it doesn't matter the perspective of that. Yes, it was because I was an arrogant rich kid who was the son of the CEO for governor. But Timmy's different.
But Timmy's not really a kid.
No, he was never a kid. I never, he looks like a kid.
One time.
Well, you know, good old Timothy Balthin.
I gotta go play with Timmy.
You'd like playing with Timmy. He's cool. He's like my only friend.
Did you pick up on that? Timothy Balthin?
Nope, he's confused.
He's like, I know that name sounds familiar.
Like Port of Balfin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Necromancer?
Yeah.
Yeah. Timmy. Timmy's like one half of his like soul stone.
Okay.
All right, so as you poof, you are now in an arid plain. The grass has this reddish, orangey hue to it.
With the one mountain behind
it. Okay. Ahead of you, you see this one giant, sharp spire rising up from the ground that kind of catches the evening, or late afternoon sun, just casting this weird shadow turning the entire plane that you're in into some kind of giant sundial. And as you're just sitting there staring, you're realizing, last time you were there, you were surrounded by trees at this point.
I was wondering that. And there was this big, giant, wannabe mountain hill that we brought the guy up.
Yeah, that's the spire.
That's still there. But the trees and stuff,
But you're on a plane.
It's a blood steal, I bet.
Probably.
It's only been a week.
Doesn't change the fact. That's my assumption.
Yep.
Being a week, I'm like, that's my assumption. It's blood steal.
I know how magic works.
Well, I know blood steal works. It's, you know, you're talking about a thing that's...
I've been watching blood steal work.
So have I, since I was old enough to remember.
I haven't.
Yeah. No, so...
I had fun with that in the last campaign.
Well, it became an army for my character, yeah. I mean...
So, what are you guys doing?
Out the car.
You do know that the village is slightly to the left of the spire from where you came in last time. Although this doesn't quite feel like where you came in last time. I will allow two of you, and you can choose who, to do a survival check, and one of you to do a history check.
I have a 4 to history.
I'm thinking sprite though, aerial.
I got a 4 to survival.
If we had a perception, that'd be great, but...
No, I know, but I'm saying...
I got a 5 to survival.
Yeah, I was thinking about popping out the vehicle. We'll get to that. Let's
see these rolls first. Yeah, I got 5 to survival. Yeah.
So you roll for survival then.
So 2 for survival. Who else is rolling for survival? Or are you letting him roll with advantage?
He can roll with advantage. I only got 3.
I'll roll with advantage for the survival, and you roll 2 in case you roll higher than me.
Well, no. There's 2 rolls for survival.
Okay.
If you're letting him take both of the rolls, then he's basically rolling with advantage.
You have a +5. Roll with advantage.
I was going to take whatever the highest roll of the 2 was anyway.
Perfect.
And then 1 roll for history.
I only have a 4 to history.
I have 2 to history.
Wow.
I get a 4.
You want to reload one of those? I would use my pixie's luck because with the pixies out, the pixie's with me.
You want to use the luck?
Yeah.
Okay, then he can reroll the whole roll.
Okay, so yeah, you get that again. Because
I have an advantage on my history. Want to use the luck on me?
You have extras, I have none.
Greg, can I have a luck?
9, 5.
What is your luck from?
The luck feat.
14. He has the feat.
It's only for you.
Yeah. 14, okay. I figured.
14 total? Yeah. Okay.
Better than 9.
Better than my 6.
And what was your total history?
6.
6?
I know shit.
Okay. So, your mind's kind of fuzzy from the whole thing.
I'm all confused.
But you're definitely aware of this is not where you came in last time. Although it does look somewhat familiar. As you're looking around, you realize... You remember very going up that spire and coming back down it. Okay? The spire was facing basically away from you. Almost like you're going up a ramp to go up the spire of it, because it was that kind of at an angle.
Right.
And now that you're looking at it, it's like the point is coming towards you.
So it's like almost like switched.
Yep.
We're on the other side of the...
Alright, so if we're on the other side than where we were last time, does that mean that the village is still on the other side of the spire that we found it at?
This could be a totally different village. If she wants us to protect.
No, same guy.
Sure? Can I ask my pixie to do an aerial sight to see if she sees anything?
Alright, do a perception check, and how long are you sending her off to? Do it.
I was just going to say, just send her up for a few minutes to see if she can see anything.
All right, so you're saying like 10 minutes?
Yeah, let's say with that.
Just as high as you can.
Go up as high as she can see, and then...
Yeah, it's determining the range of her perception of what she's scouting out.
Okay, so 10 minutes.
Okay, roll.
Base or advantage?
Perception for her, base. She doesn't have an energy sense.
3. I don't know if she's got a bonus in character. I don't have that. Sheep, but
it's over there.
I haven't seen
it. Find it again, the center.
So it's +4 or 5.
Let's see. 1, 6.
Plus perception.
Something like that. I don't remember. She's in the pixie form.
In pixie form, so that would be wisdom, right? That's a plus four.
Okay.
Nope, plus five, because she has that little bonus to it. So what's the total?
Eight.
She didn't see shit either.
Okay. She comes back down and relays to you that it's hard to see at this angle because about 500 feet up, the ground drops down a little bit, and then it continues level again, and on either side of the spire appears to be forest. She does see signs of civilization on both sides of the spire. Looks like smoke coming up from locations on either side of the spire. And also, it looks like possibly smoke coming up from another location beyond the spire. And the plane goes up for another good mile and a half before you start reaching the point where you would be like under the tip of the spire, which is another then half mile to the spire itself.
I relay the information to the group. Just open up the communicator when she speaks, if or just tell them. So it looks like there's signs of civilization on either side of the spire, and then civilization off in the distance. If we got geographically, if we're on the other side of the spire that when we started last time, then one of the villages or civilization settlements over there should be the one that we're supposed to meet up with. That has Mortius in it.
Yeah.
So,
Mortius Mortum.
So if we went to the village on the left last time, if we're coming up the other side of the spire, it'd be on the right. Am I correct about that?
Sounds about right. Mm.
I believe so. If we're coming up from the other side, if it's a long ramp up to the thing, then it should just be on the right if we came up on the left the last time. Is that metagame, is that accurate to what we came with by your description?
Probably.
I'm trying to be accurate, but I don't remember the exact wording. That was perfect.
So the side we were on before we got
honestly, I kind of dazed out while you were talking and didn't hear half of it, so.
This is honest.
You were talking metagame amongst them, and I was just kind of spacing out, looking at my screen and around at the table.
That's fair.
And debating on which battle map I'm going to ask you to pull out. Or if I should ask Greg over there to pull out a Grasslands kind of battle map. Because we're going to be doing it up something like that somewhat soon.
All right, so worst comes to worst, we'll go to the new go to that town in front of us on this side of the mountain, and if it ain't the right town, we just keep going and go to the other side.
All right.
And this way, nothing else. We at least get a recon done.
Yep. So let's head up and go to the settlement on the right. If that's not the right one, we'll head the one on the left. All right. So I guess we just I pull out the skiff, activate it, so I'm down to 186 charges now.
Okay. You pull out the skiff, hop on, and I take it your pixie driving?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
Maki.
So, you know what? Just for the hell of it, who wants to do an encounter roll for the hour and a half it's going to take you to get to the village?
Go ahead, Tom. You don't want me and Greg doing it.
I did it last time.
Yeah, we rolled hundreds and shit.
This one, right?
No, it's a 2.
Yep, you're in regular D10.
Because you're in the vehicle, anything under 75 is going to result in nothing happening. You might see something on the side.
57.
Okay. As you're going down, pretty uneventful. The drop was kind of a fun because it was a good 25-foot drop down like a good 80-degree hillside. Nice.
Punch it! No one gets a mare, bitch!
Good.
As you're progressing, you see a herd of what looks to be some type of like water buffalo or cow, but all of their fur has like a, and horns have a reddish tinge to it.
Infected.
Yep. Upon further looking, as you go by them, you can almost swear that their eyes are glowing red.
Oh, it supposedly causes some type of no, just infected. Yeah. It happened to the wildlife of the land of nowhere. No, the one my dad blew up.
So, as you reach town, the town has, it looks like they're constructing a wall around the town now, where there wasn't really much of one before. And you see a familiar appearance of a relatively beaten up Etten who is holding up logs while villagers are tying them into place and hammering them into place to, for the wall. This Etten definitely looks like it's not in as good a shape as when you left it.
It will be in a few minutes.
Okay. If you want to find out how bad, you can do a medicine or investigation check.
12.
He's down to like his last 3 hit points.
He won't be.
He's barely holding it together. The fact that they're working him this hard is almost frustrating to you because he's doing more damage to himself.
Right.
And one little accident and he's gone. But as you approach the gate, one of the villagers comes out, waves at you, big smile on his face. And as you come near, you see him pull out the hat, put it on.
ACG!
ACG. We gotta get that like printed on our skiff here.
We'll talk about that soon.
Good to see you. No one came by to give us these personally, so I had to order them. I just got it yesterday. Thanks.
Glad to help out, but thank you for wrapping our merchandise for our company. Now a division of Shell Shock Industries.
It's actually much comfortable now.
Always will be. As long as you have our hat.
Your hat does that? Oh, nice.
Would you like a few more on the house? I hand up 3.
Thank you. One for my wife, one for my kid.
Where's Mortis?
Oh, center of town. You'll find him in the lodge.
I know there.
He's been working on something that's been really stressing him out, apparently.
I call my Etten over.
Comes back over. I was... One of the heads is completely limp.
He's back to full.
Which was what, 16?
11.
11. You see him kind of straighten up. The other head kind of pops up a little bit. It's still missing an eye.
All
right. Hi, boss. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Me help.
Yes, and I'm going to help you in a little bit. We're going to get you stronger.
Me do good.
Yes, I see that.
Come. Try kill. I kill.
Good job, my friend. Hey, come on, let's go. Come
body
on, you with us.
This way if you want.
Huh?
Me save bodies on side for you.
How many?
4. As he holds up 3 fingers.
This little stump where the pinky is not there.
No, it's there. It's just sticking out that way.
Take medicine right back. There you go.
Hey. Oh, okay.
So he leads you about 500 feet away from the wall, and there's a pit that has the body of 6 centaurs in it. Okay. 2 of which are completely ripped in half. So the human and the horse bodies are separate, so it could be a horse and a half of a human, but you're pretty sure by looking at it that it was a centaur. And one of the other ones looks like it's had every bone in its body broken and smashed, because half of them are still sticking out of its hide. And then the other one looks almost pristine, except for the head is only like half there. So almost like someone went squish. Mm.
I wonder who went squish.
Good boy.
Right.
We love the end.
I said none of those are worth resing up. Just garbage, pretty much meat.
I do good, boss.
You do good, my friend.
If you want to call over my pixie to start scalping the corpses, I can make the rolls if you want.
Yeah, have her do that. If and have her check if there's anything or any one of them fully functional that you could put back together enough. Be worth rezzing.
She only has the scavenge command. She wouldn't be able
she
to do
medicine.
Much. But with their just corpses, their corpses.
All right. You took the homunculi class.
Yep.
Make a medicine intelligence check.
I took a couple of them actually. Jesus fucking Christ. My dice are hating me tonight. It's 11, 12 with the homunculi plus.
I'm sorry. It's being weird. Sorry for all the beeps.
Whatever. No big deal.
It's okay. So, what was your final roll for your medicine plus intelligence modifier?
12.
What's your medicine bonus?
6.
What'd you roll?
6. No, you rolled 5. Plus, so I got 11. 1 from Monculus.
Okay. All right. And then plus your intelligence modifier.
I'll add my intelligence to it. Yeah. This is what? 15 plus 4.
Okay.
No, 16. Sorry.
That makes a difference.
Okay.
Because it was a DC 12. So you would have missed it before.
True.
The one that has its head partially caved in. And undead don't need a brain.
Right.
It would just have a deformed head.
That's fine. But that's why I was going to have his pixie make sure
and
nothing
with
else
your was. Skills, you could probably reshape it and put it back together with about an hour and a half worth of work.
Okay.
So one of them could be usable.
Okay. Hey, non-player. Can you grab that corpse out of there for me with your hands? I don't think you want to go down the pit.
Well, that too. Or that, if you just walked around and got your hands bloody, you learn things.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Exactly.
All right. So I want you to do a dexterity check to see if you can grab the right one. This is your first time really firing off your new hands.
All right.
Practice makes perfect.
Come on.
It's only a DC 5, but the higher he rolls, the better.
Yeah.
Wait, so since my dexterity went up to 18, does that make the modifier 4? Like it is for wisdom and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's going to be the same exact
13.
Thing.
Okay.
Not bad.
As you grab onto it, you feel a bit of a tingle in your hands. You can add 3 humanoids.
Yeah, or stop the bloodshot, right?
Right.
Take care of it.
Make a strength check.
Cool.
Wait.
Yeah, I do.
Would this be a grappler pull?
Yep.
I use wisdom, not strength, with my new hands.
Yep. Because you're pulling in the energy tethers. So it's your force of will that's controlling the energy tether.
We're going to take care of it. Put him in the blood on
roll. Oh, he's going to get him up first.
Yeah. I'm going to use my other lucky for that. I rolled a 2.
And even with my modifier.
He's going to use up all of his luckies before the combat.
Yeah, I know, right?
We know what's really important. You rolled worse, didn't you?
I rolled a 2 again.
Maybe you should be using those other dice.
Yeah, you're supposed to be using the Yule dice.
Yeah, your Yule dice were luckier for you, remember?
He left those with his dice at home.
I'm an idiot and I forgot them at home.
He doesn't have his dice, he's using the spares.
You don't have any of your own dice?
I got a couple other sets of spares,
I left him at home because I'm an idiot.
If you don't have any of your own dice, then I have a solution. Because, you know,
those are not liking
you. You've been a wonderful player. I feel bad about this. Hand this over to him. Pick one of them.
Oh, okay.
Good save, Tom.
That's kind of heavy.
Unbelievable.
That's not. That's a.
That's bog iron.
Yep.
Pick lucky.
Almost purple, like my new armor. I'll put these away. Thank you.
That reroll now?
You have a mix there, you won't be able to close it. Yeah. You have a couple too many dice. At least one too many. That D6. That's not the right color.
No, they're all the right color.
Okay.
Oh.
Like, I just didn't put them in right.
Oh. I got an extra in there.
Sorry, I sacrificed my last little dice case to Fee for her extra dice. Mm-hmm. No.
I have a bunch of them. No, I just stole them all. They're all over there.
Oh, so yeah, mine's over there now because she used the dice bag that she stole from me instead.
Yep, that's right here.
So you could give him one of those if you want. That's up to you.
I think I might just sacrifice one of the spares because neither of these are that great.
Yeah.
And you get to re-roll it.
Answer the phone or I'm whooping your ass.
Do you want a hard case or soft case?
I think soft case.
Okay. Well, I'm still going to sacrifice that case.
Okay.
Oh, that was... I don't know why I use these for a new game or whatever, but...
So, third time is the charm.
These spares are being deposited into the... What?
I thought those were mine.
Oh, well, okay. Then these spares are getting tossed in there. I don't really care.
I'm positive those are not mine, but I'm pretty sure that those were one of the sets that I brought over.
It's missing one.
That was kind of a fiery set, and it was missing a
D10.
Yeah, and it's missing the D10 that only has a single digit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is significantly better.
I'm not completely caring, honestly, because they were Cass's old dice.
So should I put them in the dice bag of death?
No.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, maybe. Maybe.
18.
I don't think anyone else would explain. 18.
Everyone else has dice.
14 with my wisdom modifier.
Nice. Congratulations. So those better?
Much better.
Are we dumping into the bag of death?
Sure. The bag of dice to hand to players that we're not sure if we're going to keep in the game, right?
It's the dice bag of death. That's what we're going with. And now I get another dice case.
Sorry.
Ooh.
Breathe. That works. So you're able to draw it up. As you draw it up, you feel your hands tingle as you go through the other three bodies. And now, so you've added another three.
Add three on top of the three I already got?
Yeah. There were six bodies in there.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Dip your hands in the
blood. As he comes up, the body he's pulling up is soaked in the blood of all the bodies that he drew it through.
I take Kyle and Karen out and I dip them into it.
Start wiping them?
Yeah.
Okay. So, as you're doing this, you end up shaving off most of the fur on one of the sides.
Sorry, nope.
Yeah, we'll give it to Joe on that when he comes back.
You just keep giving him the mangled remains. It's like, here you go, Joe. This isn't usable.
Hey, once he figures out how to make a corpse golem, it'll all be usable.
So you guys flipping it over before he comes back?
Get to it right away.
Yeah. So add six humanoids.
That's total of seven now.
And it's how many? 25 for your first perk?
25 for a plus one.
Yeah. And if you're attuned with them, which you are attuned with your hands because they're now a part of your body, then you get the extra bonuses too from once you start getting there.
So what do I get for them now? Because I got seven of them though. I'm just asking to make
not yet. Bonuses, when you get up to 25, then you get plus one against humanoids to hit and damage.
That's what I wanted.
And then upon attunement, you also get other bonuses. If you ask Greg, he'll probably show you his. And you can see...
About the Bloodsteel?
Yeah.
So
it's listed from the Bloodsteel onward, exactly what the Bloodsteel benefits are. Oh, this
was my drop when you put Karen out and stuff like that for me?
Yeah.
This stuff appears for my hand specifically, but the...
Right, but he's...
The chart and the stuff above it.
That's Karen right there.
Yeah.
And I'm going to get one for Kyle, too, since he's everything's changed on him.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Well, what I usually try to do with people with their weapons and specialized gear.
I mean, like I said, I want to buy a printer. If I get one before you, I'll bring it up for a while. I'm not going to print everything. I'll be printing, using a printer all the time, so.
Yeah, no, I'm going to invest in a laser jet, and I'm just not in a huge hurry because of everything else going on right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, you pull it out for him. You're just leaving it there for him?
Set it down.
Okay.
Put it down to where the bear pie fits on the ground.
Yeah.
And what are the rest of you guys doing then? While you wait for him to come back and decide what he's doing. You know, it doesn't even splatter. The blood has soaked into your...
Oh. It absorbs it. Well, only the blood. I go into... I'm not touching my phone, so I'm not on chat right now. I don't know what's being said.
Joe, you fuckers. Mm-hmm. I had to approve it.
So I.
Oh, he just says, "You fuckers."
I was listening.
Yeah, he was shaved. He shaved half of the whatever. It's just funny.
Threw me under the bus, damn it!
Hey, you said get it out of the thing, and then you started stabbing it.
Hey, it didn't slice it up. It just shaved it.
Yeah, whatever. No big deal.
No one cares about a shaved side of an undead.
Yeah, a half-shaved centaur.
Yes.
That's funny.
The half-shaved cat, or mostly shaved cat.
Yeah.
I do head to Mortis. I go into the storage. I did deduct the energy point to activate the parcel. And I remove the box and I hand it to him.
Okay.
And I met, and I'm.
So do you want to finish at the pit before you do that?
Yeah, let's
or are you
finish
gonna scavenge first?
I send the pixie to scavenge.
Make
the
scavenge roll.
Three corpses?
Yep.
Five.
I thought it was six.
Well, we took
you
one
pulled
out.
One out.
Right, because I pulled the one out.
That he's going to screw with.
He's going to screw with the one that's intact, but. Yep. Five plus her six, I think it was.
11. All right, so it's, at this point, it's been rotting for a while, so it's, what was the?
It's only been a week.
Like, we'll second tier.
Electrum?
No, you got, I think it's silver. And then centaurs, they're worth about 50 XP a piece, so times 5, that would be 250, so 250 silver.
Okay.
It adds up.
I love that I did scavenging that way. It's just so much easier for loot table.
I thought, was that all the 10 stars or was that just one individual?
Yeah, it was just all of them.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. So is that each or the 250 total?
Total.
Okay.
Yeah, they
Thought you were making me roll for each one. That's why I was confused.
Yeah, no, they're basic low-level centers.
Okay, so just 257. Okay. Yeah.
Come on. 11 HP and took them out without dying.
Barely.
These things couldn't do 11 damage to it.
I gotta just remind me later. You guys are screwing around building the new place there. I gotta pump his ass up.
Alright. So you go to the main hall. As you walk in, you see a familiar face of the cleric that you saw before, the priest, under stacks and stacks of paperwork and what looks to be a few crates of basic crap quality weaponry.
Mortis, my friend, what the hell's going on?
He looks up frightened as hell and jumps and ends up spreading a whole bunch of his papers in a flurry, just a cloud of paperwork around him.
I love that effect.
As he looks over at you. Have you come to help?
What are you in need of help with?
Every night they've been attacking. We've barely survived. These weapons are fucking shit.
Well, it's almost nighttime. Sounds like we could have some fun here soon.
And I cannot thank you enough for the assistance of your, I still don't know what to call it, but I am afraid it will not last tonight.
He's perfectly fine now.
Really?
Yes.
Then we have a chance.
I healed him.
Oh, fantastic. I'll have the kids put the armor back on him.
He won't need much armor after I'm done.
Oh, they'll be upset. They were very proud of the armor they made him.
Well, that's fine. They can still add it on to him.
All right. I'll send the word out. And you see him, like, pull on something over on the side of his chair, and you hear a bell chime off on the side of the wall. And within a moment, there's a face that peers through. Armor up the big guy for tonight.
Okay. We have a present for you.
For me? Really?
I pull it and hand it to him. You can do the talking.
What was it? What was his name again?
Mortimer Mortis?
No, hers, not his.
Glix.
Well, her name is Merriwick Glix. Yeah.
Merriwick sent you this gift.
Oh, thank you.
She has to deliver it to you.
Oh, is this what I think it is?
Probably.
Is it truly?
Yes.
And then she pulls out a little note from behind it, opens it up. Oh, fantastique. So fantastique. Thank the gods. He starts muttering a prayer in a language you don't understand.
I wait for him to finish before I interrupt him.
And he takes the pendant, puts it around his neck, puts the piece of paper in his pocket.
Looking at the pendant, does it change?
No. It's a figurine of what looks to be a man.
So I approach, I mentioned to him now, once he's done with this prayer. So we signed a contract for some territory attached to this village on behalf
yes,
of...
Yes, the note stated, so if I may be perfectly blunt and honest with you there, Sus.
Of course.
If you want a truly good location for mining and stuff other than for the obsidian, there's a village on the other side of the spire that, well, they've been attacking us for the last, like, few months. In fact, the children that you brought to us, they were the ones that had killed their parents. And the other people that you found that were dead around them.
How are the children?
Oh, they're doing fantastic. Very, very, very well. But if you want to take that town, I'd say go for it. The leader of the town's a bit of an ass.
So, there's no real,
They have no affiliation with Toka.
Much obliged for that. That was my next question.
Yeah.
I
had a feeling.
So, we're not caring about anything, just make sure the town's not a problem and we can take the property? Is that agreeable?
As far as we're concerned, you can take out every other town around here. Hey, they're all assholes. They don't like us.
Well,
they raid us and try to take our supplies.
In the very immediate future, raids will no longer be a problem, I have a feeling.
As if it's our fault that they can't farm their lands.
But if you need farming equipment, I might know someone who could help you, but we'll talk about that later.
Well, it's not so much about the equipment, it's the ground itself. The ground does not give way very well to most plant life, so we have shipped in from the Arboretum specialized fertilizers for it. And, well, we're not going to sell it to them, because it's for us. Mm-hmm. But they're not getting happy about that.
Yeah. Well, so I think the immediate problem is the village across the spire that keeps raiding, is that correct?
Aye.
So I believe that's a territory we'll take over for the new ACG settlement. Honestly, this is... What do we know how big of a village it is? How many people, maybe?
Well, the two nearest villages, one is that over that direction he points out, where closer to where you guys had originally came in, now that you have a better idea of how the spire yeah. and stuff is reaching out. The one that you saw, like, directly ahead of you when you were heading towards the spire. Mm. That one apparently is a village of beastmen, as he calls them.
I like that.
I'm guessing that's where the centaurs came from.
And then the other village on the other side of the spire maybe. Are a centaur village.
Oh, guess not.
So
what do you that's why he was directing you to that one. The beastmen haven't been a huge deal yet.
You notice that my character's just slaughtering villages just doesn't sit well with them after his death. He just doesn't feel right about it.
You don't have to slaughter the whole village.
I walk out, grab my etin.
Merely make an example.
I mean, do
as
you want
go
to
go out to your etin? And what you guys could continue discussing. As you go out to your etin, you see that there's about 7 kids, including the 2 that you saved, that are bringing over these plates of bloodsteel and wrapping them around him and basically creating a suit of plate mail for him out of sheets of bloodsteel.
Sweet. All right, now,
very crudely hammered and bound, but...
All right, metagame real quick. What do I need to pump in more life into him? Just... My espionage.
He's already created. You can only...
You said I could add more to him later. That is what you told me. Yeah, you can rewatch the video.
Damn. Okay.
Necrotic auras, maybe.
So when you're doing the resurrect and you're stating how many spell points you're putting into hit points roll for right. him, so basically you would have to do a resurrect on him again, and only this would be a bonus effect for him. And then, so you do the original resurrect effect and then add on the spell points per hit die that you're going to be adding on to them.
Okay.
And you'd have to do the first 3, I think it's 2 or 3 hit die that you had originally on them in order to, so yeah. basically you're going to redo his hit points from 0
right.
when you res him. So however many hit spell points you can put into it, how many hit die.
Okay. So from now on, though, we'll do that right from the beginning.
Because that was a kind of a new thing for all of us at that moment.
Re-enchanting an undead body like that is a bit much.
Yeah, because I said it sounded strange to me, but at that point I still was learning the whole system, so a lot of it was kind of new to me as far as that went. So
Slutty says that her husband rage quit, so she's back. Welcome back. We're glad to have you. Sorry that he rage quit.
I'll play with you, Slutty.
I'm guessing that she kicked his ass too much or something to that effect. So do the resurrection cost plus the original hit and then just re-roll hit die from zero. However many dice you're putting into it. You have the math.
I ask Mortif.
No, the other teams were too good, apparently.
That happens a lot.
Yeah, especially weekends.
You want PlayStation or Xbox?
I ask Mortif if he's got a map of the area that I can look at.
Sure. It pulls out a map. It's a big circle with a point in the center. And you see a dot for one town, a dot for another town, a dot for another town, a dot for another town, like way over in different directions, and like three other ones.
Okay. That's enough. I call the pixie after it's done scavenging the corpses.
Yeah, that's going to take it a couple hours.
Oh, that long?
Okay. Yeah. Well, it's about 10 minutes to an hour per. You did not roll that high, and in order to get usable stuff from this badly beaten up, decayed
corpses. Okay, no, that's fine. So I referenced that the spire is the point in the middle, and then that I point to the village that we're at. I take notes, just kind of like in my communicator, whatever, or my umbrella communicator, just as far as distance parameters and general locations for the parameters of the village. So if I send the coordinates to my dad, he can plug them into a reforge.
The map.
It would mostly be
the map spacing. Is not very well to scale.
Yeah.
So
would I be able to do an approximate comparison of the territory from what I've seen without the map?
The pixie tells you straight up, you'd be better off resurveying it yourself.
Okay.
Let the pixie go out and survey it later after we've calmed down this battle.
She says, sweet, I also have computer version as well and play online sometimes.
Sweet.
Okay, so I'll just send the pixie out for a recon for data analysis so we can get some reinforcement for the god detail. Right.
So, it's early evening at this point.
All right.
I take it, anything else you want to talk to him about?
He delivered the thing, we told him why we're there, he gave us the territory suggestion, and I guess we gotta go massacre a village.
Doing them both at the same time.
Well, you don't have to massacre the whole village.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, I was going to say, you guys need to. And that's cool. I don't argue with it.
I was just going to say.
I just don't want to wander the village lightning bolting women and children. That's not really my thing.
I would say we could simply make an example out of the raiders they send.
We're taking over the entire
city. Yeah, I think that there's going to need some death.
Yeah, there's gonna
and
be
that's
a lot
cool.
Of death.
I mean, what does like hiring a brawler henchman killer from like Toka to just assist them if they need it. Like, there's no probably need, but I don't know. Like, if he can't do it, he wants to give you the means. Like, he will help you anyway, but actually pulling a trigger on this just feels dirty.
Okay. So, as you step out, you go and you, after seeing them armoring up him, you spend about an hour rezzing up what's his name from the dead, Centaur. During that hour, you guys are, confronted by some of the townspeople who offer you dinner.
I eat. I'm hungry.
Okay. The food here is basic Toka fare. Stew and potatoes.
Sweet.
In fact, it tastes just like one of the kiosks right outside of the collections office that you've stopped at a few times. Because it was the closest one to the collections department.
Okay. Nice. Good. That's good food. They're good stew. All
right. So, I'm going to let him finish before. Do you want to pull out a map for the first battle phase encounter? Or we could use Theater of the Mind. I already made it clear you guys are going to get a slight attack tonight.
Yep.
Alright, so now he has 44 hit points.
That's much better.
And now I'm going to do the same thing to my little new centaur friend.
Okay. You know the math.
Yep.
You have it all there.
I rolled a 16 for the res.
Okay.
So I left it separate just in case battle came first, so that's what I was asking you before I bothered to roll it all.
Yeah.
I saved centaur. Oh, fuck, you know what? I gotta add four more dice to that roll. I totally forgot I was four short.
We...
1, 2, 3, 4.
See how those work for you.
Right. Let's see, 9, 10, 11, 14. So, 14, so, sorry. He is 68.
68 centaur?
No, the Etna.
Oh.
I forgot to roll four of the dice. Didn't have enough.
So he's pretty much at what his original hit points was supposed to be.
The end.
Yep.
Yeah. Now he feels like a big badass again.
He just needs another head.
Now I don't have to roll the next four.
Huh?
It's the one that got melted off by lightning bolt back in the fight.
Oh, yeah, it got melted off, didn't it?
Maybe not all the way off.
So it was a one-handed, that's right.
It used to be two-headed, now it's probably just got like an extra
I had forgotten
neck.
About that, I'm sorry. Thank you for reminding me. So it's a one-handed-headed Etten.
Huh?
One-headed?
You vaporized one of its heads off as the killing blow on it.
Yeah, now that
the lightning bolt right
he says it, I remember that. The lightning bolt that vaporized the head.
Maybe not the entire...
That was the Etten I did that to.
Yeah, that...
Was it?
I thought that was a... I don't know.
Maybe not vaporize the whole head off, but the head was like...
Because there's still enough of the head there.
Yeah, I definitely still talking damage to the head. Wish I had some centaur.
A lot of ones and twos in this one.
Jeez. Like a, well, for a centaur, it makes sense.
On top of a horse mini.
Yeah, I have one of those. It's probably the best we'll get. So I have a little group.
So how many spell points is he putting into all this right before a battle?
24. Okay. Because unlike you, though, Leech, I can get spell points back.
Yeah, so I'm not too worried about that.
Yeah.
So you got it all set?
Now I just lost all my count.
Alright, so who wants to roll against whether or not he gets to complete this before you guys get attacked? So someone can roll a d20.
I'll roll a d20.
And you want to roll above 15 for it to happen before he finishes.
16.
Yeah, makes it.
Wow, 68 fucking and adding there.
You made the number.
63 for the centaur.
This is more health than us.
And 2 in the centaur.
Jeez. All right.
How many am I grabbing?
We're
not in town no more, right?
Huh?
You're in town.
Yeah. Only 4?
You're in the village.
The kids around?
Yes.
Shit.
Yeah.
Can't change Karen.
Karen's vibrating. So much innocence.
So I don't actually have centaurs. I just went with caped ranger-looking people.
You swear as you look up at the axe head that it's drooling.
Behave, bitch. Behave.
It's like pulling.
We can't go in battle now.
We're going to go kill all kinds of motherfuckers. Hold on, baby.
And this is something I can't get into. Don't mind me. I like violence, but I'm just not going to do the whole mindless slaughter of a village thing. That's not
my thing. It's not mindless slaughter.
No, this is fight. This is fun. This is how I like this shit. And now I have to get some more decoys.
Just we're actively attacked.
That's when it's fun. I mean, like I said, women and children, that's not my thing, but... I have no problem with this. This is fun. This is what we should do. This is normal. We ACG for a reason. And now I need 4 more D's. 4. I just figured I'd get all the D6s out of the way. Just because I always need to steal from people, and I'm like...
be a lot of D6s.
Well, eventually it'd be D8s. Next level for me, I think.
All right, roll for initiative.
Do I get to roll for them two separately, or do them together?
17.
We'll let them go on your turn, make it easier.
Okay.
Greg's 17. 17, right?
I don't want to go.
16.
Two. Me and Tom want to go last. You just want to watch everything.
Tom's a two, and what are you, Joe?
One. Well, no. Could add my bonus. I'm a three.
Oh, three. Well, my strength bonus?
Four, sorry.
Initiative bonus.
Initiative bonus.
Yeah. Oh, five.
Three, unless five. They roll one, it's going to be him, me, the others, and then you.
Yep. That's exactly what it turns into.
Me, you, all of the enemies, then you guys.
I just threw it on the board. I don't know if you want me to move around.
Gives me time.
Oh, that's perfectly fine.
I thought it would be fine.
So, as you can hear the villagers call out, and you look out, and you see four centaurs, each with long bows, coming towards you with spears on their sides. First up, we have Greg.
I will...
Sorry, that was me.
Remember you. Sorry.
I will... How close would 40 get me to this guy?
You'd be there.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, actually, you're just in melee range at 5 feet.
Just barely?
Just barely. I mean, you also remind you can just...
Well, yeah,
so it's not like you have to move any closer.
Yeah, but like I want to get up close and personal so I can just do with the bam-bam.
Okay, so you're going to go bam-bam?
I'm going
to
go...
Well, do you want to... Remember, all the abilities of your cloak have to... Your cape have to be activated. So if you want to add yourself haste, you have to remember to activate it, right?
Yeah, well, it's only activated like once or twice per day, depending on how we... I think it's two or three times.
That's different with mine.
Just remember, that's more AC and more punch.
Yeah, I'll activate my haste on my cape.
Okay, so you can activate your haste, so that gives you an extra attack and a plus two to your AC.
I have times two speed and advantage in dex saves as well.
Yep.
I still have
being so, you're attacking him?
I will attack him for my two regular attacks and my one additional from haste.
Okay. You want to use the dice tray?
Oh. Can I?
Yeah. That's what it's there for. You know, so we stop denting up Sam's poor table.
I had mine, but I had to move it forward.
I'm still adding my dex mod to that, right?
Yep.
The 19. I'll say my right hand.
Yeah, plus the fist itself is like already a plus one naturally.
Yep. So that's a 30-20 then.
Yeah, okay, that's a hit.
Is it 16?
That's a hit.
And a dirty 20.
That's a hit.
Okay. Gotta roll up my damage.
Keep going. So you did your attack plus follow-up attack because it's two-handed. Okay. Then you used your haste for an attack, so you also get another follow-up attack.
To 21.
That's a hit. Now, are you using flurry of blows or anything else?
Yeah, fuck this guy.
That is the best answer. Are you using flurry of blows? Fuck this guy.
Yeah, fuck this
I'm going to rip this dude apart. You're not going to have a corpse. You're just going to beat him to shit. Fuck your head. Fuck your rib cage. No more body.
I'm hitting him with what is it at this point?
Even Slooty's like, fucking wow.
Five punches. Fucking this one land.
This is a new fuck you barrage.
Because you're using a flurry of blows, it's an attack. And whenever you make an attack, you can follow up with your secondary hand.
There's six.
That's another two attacks. You're going to hit this dude six times.
22?
That's a hit.
Nice rolling.
Dude, this
this one might not hit. This
might have been Greg's
hit.
Best blind hit. That's so a hit.
You're just pounding this shit. This centaur lives, that motherfucker. It's an intimidation check if the others run, because no offense, I run.
What is your base damage per hit?
Let's see here.
By the way, your hands tingle. Awesome. As you gain another humanoid.
Let's see here. I get D6 plus 1 plus 3 plus my Holly Jolly Ring.
Okay.
On the right hand.
Oh,
every other hit.
Three out of my six punches.
Every other hit, you guys see this like flare of confetti and presents and candy cans.
Actually, the way his fists are probably moving, it probably just looks like one big confetti.
So let's see. 6 times 4 is at a base damage then of 24.
Times 6. Do him 6 times.
No, on 6 base damage is 4.
He has to make 3 gotcha. Wisdom saves.
If he lives.
Pretty much he's dead.
Fail. Fail. Fail.
If this fucker's alive, he's just holly jolly land.
Hold on.
Let's just roll up your damage and see how much how much damage you did in 6 attacks. So that's...
You have like a piece of scrap paper? This is going to be a lot to write down. Thank you. So you can start going next if you want.
You're up next. So you probably do not want to attack the one he's attacking.
So true, Pride.
The one that's going to be disintegrated but blows like Doomsday, just beat the shit out of a human.
Plus.
Probably going to be nothing to res.
Poison.
No.
Yep, so you get the D6 poison on 3 attacks. Plus your 6 attacks of regular attack damage.
One of the badasses will be in a monk.
So what's your plan? While he's rolling up his math.
I'm thinking of a static shocking the other 3 with one massive wave with like a 5 charge.
So you're going to do a jumping blast, like a electric blast, and then do the arc over to the next target?
I'm actually going to try to do shocking. Well, I don't know. I'm thinking about it.
You used the shocking aura before in order to hit things within your vicinity, but if you target it at 1...
I can arc it.
Uh-huh.
And right now I have Energy Sense active because I do have it active at all times, so I have bonus.
So that rules out the disadvantage that you would have for arcing it to a second target.
Five. Yeah, but I can also hit all 3 guys directly with Shocking Aura.
Yeah, it's just a higher cost.
Yeah. I can do more damage with a lower cost, or I can guaranteed hit on all 3 simultaneously. It's a tough bet. It's a tough bet. I mean, I'm max SP right now.
Yeah, and these things aren't that strong.
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, if I hit them with a 4 charge, that's a lot of D6s.
I can almost guarantee that this thing's dead.
Okay, if that attacking. Thing's dead that he's attacking, I can kill the other 3 in 1 wave. So I'm gonna have some fun. I'm gonna shock the fuck out of these fuckers.
Okay, make an attack for the first one.
Advantage.
And I mean, he hit on a 12. That's gotta tell you, they're not that hard to hit.
Okay, yeah, that's true. Okay, and I have advantage.
Yeah, advantage on your first roll.
Yep. Yeah, 24.
Oh, by the way, how many spell points are you putting into it?
36.
For damage?
So I'm at 7d6.
Okay.
And I just rolled 23 on the first.
That's a hit.
Nat 1. On the second.
Okay, so it does not arc to the second one.
I have a number. 54.
That's more than I can do right now.
I rolled a 1 on my first attack, so it could have been higher, but...
Oh, it could have been! You needed that! You just disintegrated that
You
centaur.
Also included all your bonus per...
Yep. Each base roll plus 1 plus 3 plus the D6 poison for 3 of the 6 attacks.
We're evil.
Okay.
Which I rolled... All 2s on, I think.
These fuckers are seriously thinking attacking this group.
Didn't go well.
I don't think these people... I don't think these centers expected there to be these people here.
36 damage to that guy.
36?
Yep.
Okay, and... Fail. So, which one did you hit? That one?
I was going to stop from the left and work my way around.
So that one's stunned. And you said 36?
Yep.
All right, and then what was your total number again?
54.
All right, sweetie.
53?
Not bad.
54.
Okay.
Combat. We're gonna be quick.
He is, as you're sinking into him, it feels so good. You can actually feel his ribs crack underneath your punches. Okay. As you pummel his chest, you realize as that last blow hits right into his sternum, that... You don't think there's a single rib left in his rib cage that isn't broken.
Going, but we'll talk to you tomorrow.
As he stands there,
I love you,
stunned, as you had stopped him in mid-run to do all this.
All right.
Okay.
Behave,
and you can see the realization on his face, realize right. that.
Thank you, bye.
What the hell just happened? As he begins to collapse to the ground. He's still alive.
Just barely, though.
On ground?
Yeah.
So, yeah. I just knocked this guy down, like, almost instantly in front of his friends. Can I try to use that to intimidate them?
Off action.
Yeah?
That's not an off action yet.
That was just your main action.
Punch the shit out of this guy, and you have only done your main actions. No bonus, no off.
And he could use another key point.
Right.
That's a 14 on the intimidation.
Any bonuses?
That's a fail. That's a definite fail.
Oh, wow, damn.
And the stunned ones automatically failed. So
he wouldn't have passed anyway.
Yeah, I'll just war cry at them.
They are now afraid of you. They are now under the effects of a fear for you.
The second guy is probably terrified.
Oh, right. He's confused, I think.
Oh, no, he's unconscious.
Well, yeah, but if he wakes up for some reason, he's also confused.
He's also gurgling instead of breathing.
I'm just saying, adding more on top of it.
You hear a bit of a whistle as air actually escapes from the punctured bone coming out of his chest.
I know, I'm just
saying. You didn't kill him. You did everything but kill his ass.
I'm just saying, if for whatever reason he pulls through, he's also confused.
He's going to take another 3d6 of internal damage at the beginning of next round.
Oh my god, I gave him internal bleeding.
Yes.
You punched him six times.
I broke all of his
metal fists.
You did 75% of his life in one round. Okay, from multiple punches.
I'm going to build a gyro on your wrist. How do we make this worse? We somehow add a gyro.
Wait, why? I will subtract one key point.
Who knew candy canes could be so deadly? Yeah,
that freaking Holly Jolly. His right hand will get
I
the gyro.
Him right in the halls.
Boom, boom, boom.
That was all I did for my turn.
That was your main action.
That was my main action. Can I order the pixie to go into Valkyrie mode?
Yeah, that's a free action.
Okay. Can I order the pixie in Valkyrie mode to do charge shot on the one of the
ones? That
would
be your bonus action.
I can do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Then I'm totally going to do that. So I just send my pixie into Valkyrie mode and send a fort. The range on that is, it's a missile.
Like 60 weapon. Feet, yeah.
Okay.
So make an attack roll.
Bonus. I don't have the chart up right now. I'm not perfect. I need to print that at work sometime. You got to resend it to the group chat at some point, though, because I can't find it.
I can print it if you want.
All right.
If you don't mind, I just need a copy.
So, energy blast, cost of 3 Magicel.
Yep.
Which shot are you doing?
What are my options?
Force blast, elemental shot, gravity, regenerative, or mark shot?
We'll do elemental and fire.
All right, so 2d6 elemental damage.
I figured you're going to do gravity, send them up 50, 60 feet, and then they'll drop.
Does she get a bonus? Does she actually have a bonus? Okay, then 7 damage. Fire
7
damage.
And that would be...
That one.
That one? 3. Okay. All right, next we have stunned... Feared and can't go any closer because of the monk.
And that dude's
internally
still
bleeding.
Shocked.
5, 10, 15, 20. And you are all just out of range of their bows. The one with the cape starts running. Move him 40 feet away. And then he's going to use his bonus action for another 40 feet of movement.
He's off the mat.
And he makes it, so he's gone.
He's off the mat.
If he'd only moved that 40 feet with haste, I'd be able to catch him.
You know, the funny thing is, I'm judging by the range of my electro shot, thinking of how much SP I have to get to top mark him and then hit him. I'm like, with the 80 feet. Nah, I won't have the range. That's unfortunate. Yeah. I did think of sniping him with a lightning bolt.
Your gun don't make it that
far? The other one starts running away, 40 feet away.
This one?
That one. The other guy's shocked, stunned right now.
Okay. Then he uses his bonus action to continue running away.
No, he's stunned.
Yeah, he's stunned. He ain't going nowhere.
And he's dying.
He's almost
dead. No, that's Greg.
That's Greg.
Greg, why you run away?
Chasing them.
I'm chasing them, no survivors.
Next we have Tom.
I think they're gnomes. They're going to die.
Well, they are in my range, though. They're 5, right?
Yep.
Yep. Each square is 5.
8. So this guy's gone too, right?
Yeah.
Oh. I'll take Kyle. No, he's too far away in that one. What's Kyle's range?
Is that 30 feet?
30. 30, 60, I think it is. Right? 30, 60?
Yeah. You could also use Karen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, you can get within this guy's range.
Bleed on Karen and throw her so she turns into a wolf and then uses her wolf attack against him. Then you can also use your Kyle.
You'd have to go over to here, though. That's as far as you
can. But we're in town.
No, you're outside of town.
Outside of town, okay.
Yeah. All the villagers are behind the wall.
I can throw her and she'll turn into the wolf?
If you bleed on her, yeah. Nick yourself on her as you throw it.
Cut myself and I throw it.
Okay.
Throw Karen towards him. And then I...
He's yours, bitch.
Okay. Make an attack roll for Karen. And add your attack modifier to it. As an extension of you.
16. 7 is... 23.
Okay. So, I believe Karen's damage is D12.
Uh-huh. I think that's what it is right now.
Gain +1 humanoid blood. Okay, so roll D12. Okay, plus your strength bonus, plus Karen's +1 bonus.
Oh, which one's 12? Right there. Eight, plus what?
Plus your strength bonus.
So it's 15.
15.
Okay, plus the +1, I think it is.
Karen, 16,
15. Okay. Oh, no, it was off from Pete's stack. Hi, boy.
16.
Didn't kill him, but damn close.
We have to hire
him. I need her sets, and I don't even know where sets.
No, it's just +1. So 16 is what you rolled total? So it's 17.
17.
Okay, now roll your second attack. Because she can attack twice.
11.
That's a hit. Nope. Now you roll a d12 again. Oh, sorry. I thought you were rolling a d20. I apologize.
7. 7 is 14.
Plus 1, 15.
Plus 1, 15.
Damn, you like 15, huh?
That's a total of 31 points of damage.
I did 36 points of damage back.
And he hasn't even spawned.
Yeah, I still got Kyle.
Yeah. So you throwing Kyle too?
Oh yeah.
Okay. So make an attack roll. Are you using any Kyle's charges?
I'm gonna use. I have used the. I don't want to see how the bolt's gonna work.
This will.
Oh, I can wrap. Why the fuck do I have
a wrap? I can finish beating this other centaur to death.
Yeah, by crushing the skull of its, you know, collapsing dead corpse. You can curb stomp.
Oh, he's obliterated his chest. It's not worth resing.
I might have obliterated his chest, but his skull's still fine.
He doesn't need a chest.
Unless you're putting some kind of other torso.
I'm gonna use the acid just because it's 3d10 damage.
Okay. So roll to attack.
12, 7,
that's
eight,
a hit.
12 and 7 is what?
19.
You know, even if we don't go massacre the Centaur village, I would be shocked if these fuckers come back again.
So
what happened? They have gods now. They killed
and we let two to run.
One of them killed literally 5 seconds.
He bebopped to death in front of us.
He leapt forward 40 feet, punched him 6 times, and he just dropped.
The other one sent a dog after us.
We thought it was an axe, but no, it was a dog. like halfway through the air, it changed from this twirling axe to all of a sudden this.
We saw the monk was still swearing.
And I swear it was made out of red metal, too.
But it was pissed.
Not to mention, I'm like still wondering if I can shoot one of them. I'm like,
it's like one 21. Of the beasts. How do you want to do this? For major overkill. He had 8 hit points left.
Kyle goes through, just cuts his head right off.
Okay. As the acid just cauterizes the wound behind, and he's just standing there for a moment with no head. As Kyle now also has another +1 humanoid.
You fuckers, stop destroying my bodies!
I'm sitting 20 feet away from you laughing.
Each one of them now, right?
Every time you get the blood of a new creature for the first time on the weapon, you gain credit.
Right, but I got once two meta out of this. I already got 7 here right now.
Well, you have 2 separate weapons.
Yes. Yeah.
Which
weapon?
So far you've gotten 7 charges basically on each weapon.
Against that creature type.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, I mean, if I could ask for a favor, we need to do what we did last time. Like when we we put a blood steel dagger under a display with donate your blood for 1 Lucutius coin.
No, don't count each hit. No. The first hit. So 8 in 8.
Somebody got like
for
a plus
every
12
creature you've drawn blood on, you gain.
Days.
All right, plus 1. So
you can have plus 1 for Kyle, plus 1 for Cannon, so it makes both 8. Because I already had 7 with.
Yeah. Okay. Brand new weapons, and you're already halfway to your first +1.
Right.
Almost. So is that the end of your turn?
That's the end of the combat.
Now, he's still alive, technically.
Yeah. What do I have left?
I just want to roll.
Well, you used your action.
Fuck this guy.
Okay, your action was to throw her and let her attack.
Right.
So she gets your 2 attacks that you would have used for that hand attack.
Right.
You threw Kyle. And killed it. That used your other attack.
Yep.
You can't really do a follow-up on that one. So, do you have any bonus action that you want to use?
Call Kyle back?
I know it's a bit late. You can rage.
Rage against the guy who's bleeding out.
As he's on the ground dying. It's like, I just kill me. I have no ribs.
We'll let Joe go now.
All right, Joe.
It's your turn.
You start hearing me scream in languages you guys never even thought of.
Stop destroying my fucking corpses!
All right, I'll destroy
my fucking army!
Okay. The Aten starts going forward as he knows he's supposed to go and beat them up. Okay. And as he's getting up there, he's like, and that's about it.
You know what? He's putting in. He's
a good boy.
Trying it.
He's
and
doing
the centaur
his best.
Is just sitting there confused, waiting for orders.
God bless him.
They're way gone.
It's really debating. So, I'm thinking about the ballistic range of my pistol, and I'm like, can I get a pot shot at one of these motherfuckers? I'm just like looking at him off in the distance, like I might be able to.
You're losing sight of him at this point.
Okay, they're at 150 plus feet.
I have an 80 movement, so I'd be able to maybe.
No, we're not going to chase after them into their territory.
If you wanted to pursue them, you probably could catch them at that type of movement, but.
Yeah, your monk ass feet could be. But let's not run into
Rebels back home. Kendron, hi. Just like right behind them.
Actually, I forgot. You're hasted, right?
Yeah.
So if you used a key point for an extra attack, because you're hasted, you'd get another bonus attack on top of that.
So I had another.
You could have done
8.
Yeah.
Could have been up to 8 him.
We just got gruesomely overpowered for this combat phase. Okay, so I think all of us could just murder them.
Well, these are the kind of level you would have gone up at, like, when you first
so
level.
True.
Yeah, so do you imagine the big head from the Knight of the Museum out for the end? You a big dum-dum, you bring me gum-gum. That's pretty much the dumb voice I was trying to use.
Right.
Oh.
Okay.
Me smash. Oh, no smash. Nothing to smash.
Good boy.
He already smashed.
I'm sure he's just about bled out by now.
Yeah, with these, I mean, this not
just gurgling up blood.
You can seriously just watch him die. It takes like maybe 2 minutes.
I'm not giving him the pleasure of bleeding out.
So you're just going to wait your turn?
My turn's just yelling and screaming at these guys. Save me some fucking bodies here.
Tell the head and go get me a tree.
Okay. So, before you have a chance to take your turn, you watch as the as you're reaching back to go for your next punch, it just takes its last breath and slumps. As it slumps, it starts leaking its guts and stuff out of the battered remains of its chest.
Damn it, I was supposed to do that.
Do you want me to res him again just so you can hit him again?
I call out to my pixie and tell her to go back to pixie mode. And then I look over at you. Scavenge, claim. Up to you.
I'd say we take two heads, stick them on a fucking stake, facing that way.
It won't really matter if we intend to kill the whole village.
Oh, do I get plus one humanite?
No, but in case others decide.
You'd already hit him.
You already hit him once.
And if then you go over and hit the other one, you can get another plus one.
I never added the plus one from him.
Oh, yeah, you get plus one from him, and then if you go over and hit the other one, yes. You get a little bit of his blood, you get plus one from him.
Can I go over and just hit the other
one? Okay, and I take it you're going to go over.
Yeah, I'm going to
Karen walks over and takes a bit of a nibble out of it. You kind of sit there and wipe Kyle. You get a bit of a tingle.
So now we get another one, right?
So I guess we'll claim the heads and post them up, and then I'll send the pixie to fix the rest. All right, so me and him are going to go chop the heads off the
centaurs,
go stake them out, and then I'll send the pixie to scavenge the rest of the corpse. So
okay.
Actually, just one dice was enough, but that's a
well, if you need to mount them,
six,
I can help
so
you with that with my medicine.
A scavenge, plus five. So
I don't think we're really
silver.
Caring.
So 100 silver?
Yep.
Minus the head, so 80 silver?
Excellent.
No,
really well.
I'll give you the full. The head's not a whole lot to terrifying. Scavenge.
Okay. We took the heads, piked them up, and then scavenged the rest of the bodies. Yeah. And we aimed them towards the enemy village of the things that we're going to probably destroy shortly.
Okay.
Yep.
So
intimidation.
You guys camping out for the night?
We'll go back to the village. I mean, we don't have to.
Yeah, the village is let you know. Okay, they probably won't be back tonight. They usually only come once a night.
I call Karen back to hand, put her back in the axe and put her in a holster.
I know this job!
This is when you know he's really getting into character and shit. No, we're not going to town yet! Damn it, motherfuckers, no!
Let me put my dog away!
Oh my god, that's awesome.
I haven't muzzled it yet.
Yeah, muzzle will in the fucking village. We I don't want to have to
the bitch isn't trained, man.
Oh god, we don't want the children that we see killing by our pet later. That'd be funny.
I saved you! Oh shit, my cat just ate it!
I guess saving it was just, you know, just, you know.
I'll save you for go pet food later!
All right, so we're going to take a break here.
Oh, my God.
It's 10:20. So let me know, honestly, guys, and I want to make this clear first and foremost before we start planning for
Craig's
it.
Pregnant. Oh, sorry.
That would be a beautiful Warforged baby.
So here's where we get into some weirdness. Fee's getting out of work in a half hour. Do you guys seriously want to destroy a village and take it over tonight?
I don't think she's going to want to do that to Claire.
Oh, I'm thinking she will.
Yeah, she wanted blood earlier. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You give her half a chance to be, like, cruel and vengeful, and she will definitely take you up on it.
Okay, so I'll go get the jungle village map.
Do that, but all right.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you guys seriously want to make it as a bit of a late night tonight and destroy a village?
Hell, even for the fun, I'll join in.
Yeah, I don't mind staying, actually. Yeah.
Since you guys ruined my fact that I could have gotten more fucking from my army.
Okay. So then...
a town!
No, this is a village. If I want a town, I have towns over there.
All right.
Sorry, I'm OCD about maps. It's my
fault. Nah, it's fine.
So, now...
what's the general occupation?
Here's how we do general population for a village. You ready?
Yep.
Who wants to roll a D100?
I'll roll that one. Trying to score high. Me or Greg.
You could roll and take the higher one.
Up five. Somehow I don't think
five.
Okay, so there are five.
Get
five.
Children?
Big guards.
Oh, big guards.
38.
38 villagers. That sounds good.
Probably 52 just counts.
52 children.
Yes!
Not just the men, but the women and the children.
So, five big guards.
52.
The kids, you can just release them.
Yeah. And then there's Someone, let's see. So five big guards.
Okay, I was just going to write it up.
How many small guards, town guards,
okay.
People with weapons?
34 villagers. Right? And it was 52 kids?
Yep.
He had a bad article on that one.
How many are likely to attack? At least 20 of the adults?
The kids won't attack.
Not the, so 36?
Okay. Of the adults, 30, you figure at least half of them are considered the... Yeah, it's a rabbit village.
We don't even have to hurt the kids. We'll just let his friggin' axe go. Karen, there it is.
We got episode 2 up in here. Not just the men, but the women and the children. So
no, I have no problems killing women. That doesn't bother me one bit.
Neither do I, but so, I mean, this
yeah,
one,
so,
I guess we're going to go psychotic tonight. We're just going to murder people.
Yeah, so... You know, let's be completely legitimately fair, and we'll say it's an even split male-female. Females are watching over the kids. We'll be old school. I'm not sexist. I'm just
so 17
playing math
men
the simple
with
way. 17 men with...
So we'll go rape and pillage.
We going dark up in this bitch?
The women will be much more.
Usually. Wow, I didn't know we were going that dark, but
it's
go
a
for it.
We'll let the machine have his way with him.
No, I just want to pillage.
You have a detachable penis.
Maybe some arson or something? I don't know. That's all I wanted to do.
So I'm going to put a break in the video itself here.
We need an adult warning for the rest of that video.
My recording purposes.
What are we going to do? We're going to light the children on fire. We're going to enslave the people.
Oh, I already
if you're enjoying...
I'm going to pop a fire candy and start smacking houses.
All right, so if you're enjoying watching, please feel free to like, subscribe,
share.
Give us to your friends, and come back for the next one because this is going to be one evil motherfucking shit.
Welcome
crap.
To the adult group.
Welcome so, to you get angry around.
I will actually put the stream back on in just a few moments because, you know, might as well have it open stream while we do this because we're going to be waiting around for about a half hour before Fee gets back at this point. So putting a break in here. Thank you. Gotta hit this button.